You said you work with Terence Blanchard. How did you come together with Terence?
Well, I was an assistant in Manhattan Center Studios, where he was doing a lot of work. He did a number of Spike Lee films there. So as an assistant engineer, I was just, there helping set up mics and stuff like that. But I got a chance to at least watch him, watch his temperament. Just a really easy dude.
Yeah.
You know, he's and the ease that he has, kind of ease that only comes when you're confident. You know, you don't trip off.
Yeah.
And he doesn't seem to have an ego problem or anything like that. Just a really nice guy to be around.
Very pleasant person, isn't he?
Yeah, and he seemed exactly the same when I ran into him again about 3 years ago, when there was a project happening at the Hollywood Bowl, and it was the music of Spike Lee films.
Yeah.
And Terrence was on, he put the band together, I think probably most of the music was his, I guess.
Mm-hmm.
And then Chuck and Flavor came out and sang Fight the Power. In front of Terrence's band, so it's going to seem like it's the same dude. Just a really cool, like, it's a really sweet guy.
How did you come together with Chuck D and Public Enemy? You meet him?
Through one of Chuck's artists, an artist named Kyle Jason, who's a singer on Chuck's label.
Slam Jams.
It was before Slam Jams. Yeah. I can't remember what the name of that label was, but Kyle had seen a band that I was in. Mm-hmm. He liked that band. And we had connected, and through that connection, I did some work with Kyle, really good stuff.
Mm-hmm.
And then eventually met Chuck, and I think Chuck just liked the way I did things, and then he wanted to have a band behind Public Enemy. He called and asked me if I could do it. So, but I met him from Kyle Jason.
Yeah. And you immediately said, yeah, I'm into that.
I thought about it for a minute.
Yeah.
I thought about it for like 30 seconds.
And to get mass appeal, you have to water yourself off a bit.
That, if you don't have much substance, that's what you have to do. But I believe in the Quincy Jones, Nardo Michael Walden thing. If you do it, you do it with not just passion. Passion and fire are not necessarily the same thing, you know? You gotta do it with fire and passion and quality, and it will strike those who are willing to do anything.
Yeah, sure.
It'll motivate those that can actually do something.
Well, media is a very powerful thing. People underestimate, I mean, the politicians don't underestimate it. John McCain was trying to sue Jackson Brown, I think, because Jackson Brown didn't want him to use his music.
Yeah.
But imagine that. Man doesn't want you to use his music, but you sue him because he doesn't allow you to.
Yeah.
Where's the sense in that?
Yeah, what are you going to get? So we're going to not play it after that?
Yeah.
Are you going to play his music after that? No, and knowing that nobody, having the world know that this artist didn't even want you to use it.
Can you imagine that?
How stupid do you think people are?
Yeah.
Well, that's why he lost, because he really thought people would vote for that woman.
Yeah.
And the people thought that he was stupid.
But she was a very clever lady, there's no doubt about that. I couldn't believe the mistake he had made when I saw her speak the first time. I just couldn't believe that he had done that. I thought, oh, wow,
I know this is a music thing, but I just want to touch on that real quick. He was a sacrifice, and he knows it.
Yeah.
He knew that the Republican Party had no hope of him winning. So he just took the ball and threw it downfield, said, well, let's see what's happening. He said, I'm not going to go down without a fight.
Yeah.
And he went
for it. He's a real Vietnam vet, there's no doubt about that. I have a project with Bootsy Collins.
Yeah, Bootsy's, when James Brown passed away, Bootsy, he really felt that because he worked with James as a kid, So this year we embarked upon a James Brown tribute tour. He put some of the old JBs back together, including his brother Catfish, who was also a Bootsy brother.
Yeah, I remember.
And we went around Europe, did a number of the festivals this summer, and we did a bunch of big festivals in Japan, and did just all James Brown numbers. And he asked me early on, when he wanted to just do one James Brown tribute show in Cincinnati, he asked me to come to Cincinnati and be the production supervisor.
Nice.
I said, okay, sure. And I did that. Then he said, like a couple of days after, he wanted to take it on the road. And he said, I'd like you to be the production supervisor for that tour. He said, but you have to play too. And I'm like, well, way, you know. And as time went on, I had the opportunity to put together an opening band for the tour. So I put together a band with some musician friends from New York, plus the guitar player from Public Enemy, Kari Wynn. We put together a band and we called it Escapism, named it after James Brown's song.
I think I heard about that too, yeah.
And we just played James Brown instrumentals, you know, some of the great instrumentals, and we opened up the shows doing that. So that was really cool. Bootsy's just another, like, just
he's
real
great.
Quality dude, yeah. Real quality. The end of 2007, Public Enemy went to Beijing to do the Beijing Pop Festival.
I heard about it too,
So after the show, the band went home the next day, but I stayed for 4 days and I did my radio show from Gibson Guitars has a showroom there. And I'm a Gibson artist, so I booked the studio, booked the showroom and did some interviews there, a couple of the local bands. And I met a few people, one thing led to the next, and one label there called Bing Mansua, I think it's called in Chinese, but it translates literally into Maybe Mars.
It's a record label?
That's the name of the label.
Okay.
They hired me to produce one of their bands called Demerit, and that band is just an incredible band. Their webs, I think their MySpace page is MySpace.cn. I think they have an American MySpace page too. / Demerit. Great band. I mean, just one of the best bands I've heard in a long time. You know, and so they hired me to produce their album.
That's nice.
And I produced the album, and the album got really great reviews. It was called the best punk album ever produced in China.
Yeah.
Now people might say, "Well, what does that? You know, what does that mean? It's China.
Count the people."
What it means is, count the people. And China has a huge punk scene.
Yeah.
You know, we don't know about it,
sure.
But they have a huge punk scene. So it was a great honor for me.
Mm-hmm.
And also produced a single for a band called Brain Failure.
That's good name.
They sound just like the Clash. So that's either going to work for them or it's going to work against them.
Yeah.
But Chuck guested on that record. So I spent 14 days one trip and then 11 days the next trip producing those two things, and it was a really real eye-opener. You know,
interesting, isn't it?
Yeah.
The world is not, I mean, once you get in there and see how people are actually working, it's a whole different
thing. Whole other
thing.
I mean, talk about a different world.
Yeah, sure.
That's different world, you know. But check out those two bands, Brain Failure and Demerit.
We will. And what about, you have any plans to go back there in the future?
Yeah,
what's up?
They want me to do their next album.
Mm-hmm.
They're looking at doing the next album sooner than later. And I was approached by...
You better move to China then.
Well, you know, they got to work on that pollution problem.
Yeah.
I can't take my child over there.
No, of course not.
But I was approached by a big ad agency. Here at home in Seattle, about doing a residency for Nike, Converse shoe company. They want me to do a producer's residency for 3 months, producing, teaching engineers and producers how to produce music.
Okay.
Over in Beijing, so looking forward to doing that. That was supposed to actually be happening this December,
right now.
But my schedule wouldn't allow it, and I think the fallout of the Olympics lasted a lot longer than anyone expected. So the agency wants me to. They gave me a whole year to do it, so I can do it. Now and this time next year. So that's going to be good. So I do plan on going back sometime soon, and I got to figure out when Bootsy's thing is going to happen. And see what Public Enemy has on this docket thing, so I can get 3 months, because they want me to do a 3-month block.
Yeah.
So I really want to do that.